What's up, everybody? So today's video is a pretty cool one. One of the most frustrating things about AI is when it repeatedly gets the answer to your question wrong. And sometimes it can be really challenging to fix. If you've built a custom chatbot using Chatbase, then it's important that the responses it provides to questions is accurate and represents your business well. This is something that's very important to our team at Chatbase. But in order for your AI to get all of the answers right about your particular business, you do have to provide it with all of the right information. So we've built several different ways for you to be in full control of the data your AI is using to generate responses, all the way down to specific questions. In this video, we'll go through the four best ways for you to improve your custom chatbot's responses. I'll show you how to test instruction prompts inside of our new playground feature, revise inaccurate responses inside of our chat logs, and answer specific questions inside of our Q&A data source. Oh, and finally, how to map URLs using a link document. This will be everything you need to have an extremely accurate custom chatbot that performs exactly how you like. Before I jump into this, if you're not already a Chatbase user, what are you doing? Go ahead and sign up. It's completely free. Go ahead and go to chatbase.co and create an account to get started, and then you can follow along in this tutorial with me. Now, if you're ready, let's go ahead and jump into my computer and go through these Chatbase features together. Okay, so here we are. Chatbase now has this incredible new testing playground area that is right here on the main dashboard of each chatbot you create. To use it, just click this little button. This is amazing because now you can tweak your instruction prompts until it aligns perfectly with your goals. You can try different models. You can use this temperature slider to adjust how creative your chatbot is and its responses. And most importantly, below that, you can adjust the chatbot instructions or choose a preset option. You see, you can make these changes here and test right in this chat window beside it, but they won't be saved until you click the Save to Chatbot button. This is great for quickly iterating and figuring out what kind of instructions are going to give you the exact kind of performance you're looking for from your custom chatbot. This is great, and it's allowed me to really dial in the chatbots I'm building a lot quicker because I don't have to save and then go over to a different page. It's all in one place. I can quickly add different sentences to the chatbot instructions and then see how they perform immediately. Next, you can use the Q&A data source inside the data sources page to further clarify the perfect answer for any frequently asked questions that you might have. That way your chatbot is prepared to give perfect answers every single time. So you can add each question one at a time here. See, it's very simple. When you're ready, you just click the Retrain Chatbot button and the new information will be added into the data. Now that you have that dialed in, you're going to want to revise inaccurate responses that your chatbot may be providing its users. Your chatbot's performance here can vary based on the data that you've provided the chatbot. It may be requiring some information that you expect it to know. So the best way to figure out where the holes in your data are is to use the chatbot and then ask it common questions that you would expect to be asked, and then go to your chat logs to revise those responses. As you can see here inside of the chat log, there's a revise answer button beside every message. All you have to do is click the button and then fill in the responses you're looking for under expected response. This is super effective for really dialing in your chatbot over time, and it's something that you should monitor throughout the lifetime of your chatbot from time to time. See how it's performing in the real world, being used by real users, your real customers, and then continuously revise those answers and improve them so that it performs better and better over time as you feed it more data. This can make a real difference in the performance of your chatbot, and you should definitely use this feature. You can also keep an eye on this confidence score here and use it to judge what messages you want to pay attention to when you're reviewing the chat logs. And finally, the last thing that you can play with is URL mapping. This one is a bit different because it's not part of the words that your chatbot is crafting in its responses. When Chatbase crawls your website, it pulls in all the links. It will actually link your chatbot's user to whatever link on your website the user might need. For example, a sales agent chatbot might drive traffic into your lead signup form or whatever. But sometimes it can get the links wrong depending on how your website is set up. But a great way to make sure it gets the links right every single time is to create a document inside of your data sources that organizes all these links and provides definitions for the chatbot so it always knows which link to use. So the solution here is really simple. So you want to do this for signup forms and lead magnets anything that's essential for driving users into your funnel. So let me walk you through how to set this up. So you can either upload a text document outlining each URL with the title of the page and a brief description, or you can just enter them in here in the text data source field. I'll paste in this example here so you can see exactly what I'm talking about. This way your AI always knows which link to use. And of course, now you just need to retrain the chatbot and your changes will be live. After making all these changes, your chatbot should be running better than ever before and will be ready to take on anything that your users can throw at it. Providing accurate responses as often as possible and truly providing an exceptional experience for all of your users. Okay, I hope this one helped you out, guys. Thank you so much for watching to the end. If you have any more questions about how to use Chatbase, drop a comment and let us know and we'll get back to you. And if this video was helpful, please drop a like so that we know what kind of videos to be making every single week for you guys. Yeah, we drop videos every single week about Chatbase in detail, all of the different features. So if you want to get a better idea of what's going on inside of Chatbase, watch some of our old videos. We have all kinds of videos that you can use to further familiarize yourself with all of Chatbase's different features. And we're also adding new features just about every week. So keep an eye out for new videos. Hit the subscribe button because we're releasing features constantly. And we have way more coming up in the next couple months. So thank you guys so much for watching again. I hope you have an awesome day and I will see you in the next one.